Urban Dictionary defines a hater as someone that cannot be happy for another person's success. And rather than be happy, they would choose to expose a flaw in said person. Well, by that definition, Katt Williams is not only one of the funniest people of our generation, but he's also one of the biggest haters. Welcome back to the Clapback Corner. Let's get right into it. Katt Williams is known as being one of the most eccentric and funniest comedians of all time. From having some of the funniest and best-selling specials to a slew of movies, at least we forget he signed to Cameron to drop an album. Dipset, Dipset, Dipset. Yeah, that actually happened. But as of late, Katt has been more synonymous with old shit headlines than funny ones. Now, in a recent radio interview, Katt Williams expressed how he felt about the new rising stars in Black Hollywood, Hannibal Buress, Gerard Carmichael, and Lil Rel. He also mentioned Tiffany Haddish. But for the guys, he said that all of them were ugly and they couldn't pull any chicks in Lenox Mall. Now, I know what you're thinking. That's not so bad, calling somebody ugly. I just want to remind you that many of fights were started because somebody or their mama got called ugly. Now, when it comes to Tiffany Haddish, he said that she hadn't been on any tours and that she didn't have a comedy special. Both of which are ill-warranted, because she does. She does have a comedy special, and she has been on tour. Listen, Katt Williams is definitely on something different right now, but we're still trying to rock with him. But in that interview, he also got into it with the host. He said that she was fat and that she couldn't cook, and these insults may have been the reason why he was chased from the club later that evening by the host's husband, allegedly while he was holding a gun. Now, when Katt was asked later on about the gun, he was like, there was no gun. He responded with,
why would he have a gun and not use it, boo-boo? That's not who pulls a gun out and doesn't use it. I don't know what you're talking about.
Now, so many people involved in this beef, I don't even know where to begin. But let's start at the biggest name in comedy today, Kevin Hart. Kevin Hart usually takes a neutral stance on all subjects and topics. But today, he got time, cuss. In a recent interview he did on The Breakfast Club with Tiffany Haddish, he expressed exactly how he felt about Katt Williams' remarks. He talked about how Katt had that spot. Katt had the number one spot. But Katt chose drugs. He chose to make the studios look at him as a risk. And he didn't use his platform while he had that number one spot to put people on the way that he has. Now, Katt and Kevin have been going back and forth for years. This is nothing new. But this is the first time we've seen Kevin Hart actually take a stand and give his personal feelings and opinions on the situation. Bravo, Kevin. I was here for all of it. When it's all said and done, no matter what you do or what you don't do, everyone's just not going to like you. That's unfortunate that these comics can't put that beat to the side or at least settle it so we can get the next Coming to America or the next Harlem Night. But I am excited to be in a time when women are finally getting their just due, especially women of color. They being able to be let on stage and get a chance to shine. I just wish everyone realized that there's enough stage for everyone. This is Clapback Corner. I'm Tahir Moore. We'll see you next time.